from all points on the globe, the world's greatest skaters will descend upon Salt Lake City, the first American town to host the Winter Olympics in 22 years. Now, a look into the future, as many of figure skating's finest take the same ice that today serves as the canvas for the four continents championships. Five-time U.S. champion Todd Eldridge arrives fresh off a silver medal at the recent U.S. Nationals. The 96 world champ continues a comeback bid that is focused on one clear objective, Olympic gold. Matt Savoy, the surprise U.S. bronze medalist, may be overshadowed by his celebrated countrymen, but now he has a chance to gain respect on the international stage. And Michael Weiss, the reigning world bronze medalist, seeks redemption. He's here to prove that his recent struggles are an aberration, not a trend. Meanwhile, the electric Canadian pairs champions, Jamie Selle and David Pelletier, look to rekindle the fire that allowed them to burst onto the scene last year. They'll meet the explosive duo from the Far East, Xue Shen and Hung Bo Zhao, and the two-time American champs, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, who have yet to strike gold on the international scene. In the city that will yield Olympic glory, the Four Continents Championships are next on ABC Sports. Salt Lake City, Utah, the mid-sized western city at the base of the snow-covered Wasatch Mountains. Less than a year from becoming the epicenter of the entire sports world. Today, much of the figure skating world has converged here to skate for a major international title as we welcome you inside the Delta Center to kick off our coverage of the ISU Four Continents Figure Skating Championships presented by MCI WorldCom. The pairs and the men take the ice this afternoon. Tomorrow, we're back with you here on ABC Sports as the ladies and the ice dancers skate for the gold medals. And hi, everybody. I'm Terry Gannon. North America, Asia, Africa, and Australia, the four continents that are represented here in Salt Lake City this weekend. Skaters from 13 different countries from around the globe who have gathered here for an event which 3 years ago was designed as a complement to the European Championships. Now, that event has always given skaters from Europe a chance to get in front of the international judges, gain some momentum, and gain some exposure just prior to the World Championships. And now skaters from other countries around the globe have that same opportunity. The pairs are up first this afternoon. We welcome in Olympic champion Peggy Fleming right now. And Peggy, a deep, talented pairs field here. Two marquee names at the top.
Well, Terry, two of the most outstanding pair teams in the world are here in Salt Lake, and they are leading the pack after the short program. The Canadian champions, Selle and Pelletier, are in first place, and they are poised to defend their four continents title. And in the short program, Jamie and David drew in the audience with their dramatic blend of passion, charm, and musicality. And it still amazes me that this couple has only been together for 2.5 years. And in second place are the Chinese, Shen and Zhao. And their short program was just as breathtaking, but for different reasons. The height and distance she travels in the throw jumps could maybe interfere with migrating birds. It's a distance of more than 25 feet. And these two couples have very different, very strong styles, and I think either one of them could bring down the house.
Yeah, different style. Charisma against power in terms of this rivalry. Now, here's what the matchups head-to-head look like for the past two seasons. You look at the win at Skate America, got things rolling for Selle and Pelletier early, but last season in Nice, the silver medal for the second straight year for Shen and Zhao of China. Right now we turn to Olympic silver medalist Peter Carruthers. Peter, right behind those two, the Americans, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, the U.S. champions the past two seasons.
Well, certainly there's a lot of excitement with this team. This is an important event for Ina and Zimmerman. They're up against the top two teams in the world. And when they execute their lifts and throws, they can be very exciting, as we see here in this ABC stro motion. Now take a look at Kyoko as she's thrown on this huge jump. Three rotations, we're not counting rotation, but look at the air position that she has. Very nice, a little bit of a lean, but what impresses me most is the fact that when she hits the ice, she's leaning slightly, but then she snaps that back into a perfect landing position. That's what Tamara Mosvina is working on. However, these two can make careless mistakes, and that can cost them, so they want to skate clean here.
But they are very much in the hunt right now as we check the standings going into the free skate. At the top, it's the Canadian champions, Jamie Salle and David Peltier, just ahead of Shannon Zhao of China, then Ina and Zimmerman trying to hold off the Wurtzes from Canada, and rounding out the top five right now, Tiffany Scott and Philip Dulabon of the U.S. They are both from Harbin, China, a skating mecca in that country. 21-year-old Qing Pang and Zhang Tong, who is also 21 years of age, sixth place after the short program. Four times they have come in second at the Chinese National Championships.
The music is from the Red Poppy Ballet Suite.
These two can be exciting, but they have trouble with consistency. At times, unexpected mistakes creep into their program. Let's see how they set the tone here on this opening. Split, triple twist lift. Look at the speed coming out of that.
Now they're side by side, triple toe loops. Very nice.
Wow, did she go high? That was huge. I know that feeling because when I used to throw my sister, you'd say, whoops, that's a little bit too much. But she managed that height very well.
I have a feeling Kitty managed you pretty well all those years, too. Probably still does.
Let the truth be known.
Side by side, flying camels, a little out of sync. Gonna be a little more stretched out.
They both started out as single skaters in China, their hometown, and their previous coach brought them together to skate pairs 7 years ago. His parents are government officials, and her parents are retired. Finished fifth in this event the past two seasons.
Well-matched couple, beautiful body line. Yes, very nice posture.
Notice the dismount, half twist. It's not enough just to exit out with an edge. You have to do something interesting, and that's what's happening in the sport now with the lifts.
Triple loop back outside edge. Oh,
can you create a height?
That was wonderful.
What amazes me is Chinese pair teams really have some of the best throws in the world today. They've really studied the mechanics that are involved and mastered it.
Wonderful stretch, and watch the free leg on his part. When they exit this, it gets up so high. Good stretch.
It's got to be a help too to be able to train alongside a two-time world silver medal team like Shannon Zhao.
It really is. It
has to be inspiring.
Yeah. They all live and train at the College of Physical Culture in Beijing. Live in dormitories there.
Mm-hmm.
That was great.
Mm-hmm. I think they have a lot of potential. I really like them together. They just had a little rough around the edges, but I think they had some nice quality.
Been inconsistent. You never quite know what you're going to get when they take the ice, but when they're on, there's no doubting their talent.
Once again,
that's for sure. Qing Pang and Zhang Tong of China.
China.
Talent they have plenty of, and great height on this split triple twist lift. Notice how lateral she is in the air, though. She's way up in the sky, as you would say. He's about 6 feet, so she's 6 feet up in the air. Amazing. Good speed coming out, too, as they exit that difficult lift. And then I am so impressed with the height on that throat, about 3.5 feet in the air. Unbelievable.
And there's a look at the judges working here, an experienced panel, and there are judges from Europe, even though there are no European skaters in this event. Peter, what about the requirements?
Well, in pair skating, it's important to balance out everything. Pair spins, side-by-side jumps, death spirals, and of course, musical expression ties it all together.
Now, these are going to have to be pretty good. It's hard to pick that program apart very much at all. The first set for technical merit, 5.0 up to 5.5 the range.
5.3 and 5.3.
Well, they had some key throws in there that really get the judges' attention. Lifts were quite good.
5.1.
Now the second set for presentation, 4.8 up to 5.4. And that's the area they've been really working on, trying to get better. And those marks are a little bit lower. But overall, Hang and Tong of China into the lead so far here in the free skate. And when we come back, the Americans, Tiffany Scott and Philip Dulabon in fifth place after the short program. They'd love to stand on the podium for the second straight year in this event.
Welcome now, Tiffany Scott and Philip Dulabon.
And stepping onto the ice right now here in the Delta Center, the team that has won the silver medal at the U.S. National Championships the past two seasons. They're currently in fifth place overall, Tiffany Scott and Philip Dulabon. Won the bronze medal in this event last season.
And this is a great opportunity for them to be seen by the international judges. Do a really good performance here.
The first element in this program really could tell a lot because they have trouble from time to time. The side-by-side, triple toe loops.
First the double axle, and she's having trouble with that, and they turn, and now the triple toe loops, and she falls. She fell on that in the practice, the warm-up. So this is something that has troubled this couple for a long time.
Wow, she really, you saw the leg kick through. Quite a collision on that. Not as desirable as a smooth exit. To do the triple toe loops at the beginning of the program, but they subbed out to the double axles, trying to play it a little more safe.
Well, Tiffany's been battling a bit of a knee injury, which she sustained in late December, so it's not really affecting her skating much now, although it still is tender. This team did not enjoy one of their best performances at Nationals, but they did again win the silver medal, and it was enough to keep them on the world team for the second straight year. They and Ina and Zimmerman will be competing in pairs through the World Championships here on ABC March 24th and 25th from Vancouver.
And now this throw, double axel. Nice and confident. Transitions are a little rough, not real smooth, they don't have enough speed.
Now, 4 minutes into the program, their mission is to really attack the end here, this footwork step sequence.
Speaking of taking a toll, remember the altitude too. We're better than 4,500 feet above sea level, and certainly been a factor with the skating this week.
And your upper body really can tire in pair skating because of the demand of lifts. I thought they did okay. I don't think it was their best performance. They were a little bit off on their elements, not really in sync. But okay.
The bronze medalist in this event last season, it would be awfully tough to repeat that. And of course, the field is much deeper. We've been saying that all season long. There are so many great pairs teams out there in the world, and some of them right here competing in Salt Lake.
And here was this wonderful triple twist they did toward the beginning of the program. Good lift, good split. Very tight in the air, but she like bangs into him on that landing, and it was is very rough, and it disrupted the flow out of that element. And this was their throw, triple Salchow, taking off from that back inside edge, and he throws her up in the air. Not too much lift, but she finishes it, and it's a solid landing. The mark
for technical now. They're along with one of their coaches, Carl Kurtz, now as they await the marks. There'll be two sets as always.
5.0.
The first, 5.2, the technical 5.1, merit 5.2, for the team that finished ninth 4.6, at last year's World Championships. 4.8, here they are, 4.6 up to 5.3, the range.
And 5.0.
Well, they had a very rough start in their program by missing that key element of those side-by-side triples and the side-by-side double axles.
And now the presentation marks, Peggy, 4.9 up to 5.5. So we'll have to wait and see how the marks for Scott and Dulabon will hold up throughout the pairs free skate. When we come back, Yoko Ina and John Zimmerman, who just missed winning this event last season. They've won two straight golds at the U.S. Championships. They go for gold again today. Continents Figure Skating Championships presented by MCI WorldCom, the pairs free skate. Continues Terry Gannon along with Peggy Fleming and Peter Carruthers. Here is the team in third place after the short program. The two-time and reigning U.S. champs, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman. They captured the silver medal in this event last season.
And they're skating to variations on a theme of Paganini, arranged by Andrew Lloyd Webber.
I spoke with Tamara Mosvina before the competition, and she told me that the psychology for John Zimmerman is to treat it like an exhibition because she feels he gets too nervous when in competition mode.
Well, this will be the first test as these side-by-side triple toes. And he faltered on that landing. side-by-side double axles.
Split triple twist lift. To one hand. Now notice they just do a normal exit. There's no flip out or half twist dismount.
Very nice throw, triple loop, looked very easy.
When you talk about Salle and Peltier only having been together 2.5 seasons or 2.5 years, this is only the third season for Ina and Zimmerman. Remember, Kyoko is only the fourth American skater ever to win national titles with two different partners in pairs. She won a couple of them with Jason Dungeon in 97 and 98. These two barely missed qualifying for the Grand Prix final in Tokyo. They are the first alternates. Should anyone drop out, they would go to Tokyo. Our coverage, by the way, final begins February 18th with the ladies.
Nice variation.
Spread eagle position.
Very unusual.
And hard.
Yes.
And dangerous.
This throw, triple sow cow, this back inside edge takeoff.
She's right on top of her throws.
They look very controlled.
I know he studied Artur Dmitriev because I can see the movement in his body is very much like Artur's. Artur Dmitriev, of course, two-time Olympic champion in pair skating. Nationals, they had a fall right, or a slip right here, and it was at this point of the spin. They get through it just fine.
They took that a little more carefully.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yes.
Hey, they turned it up a few notches after that early stumble, didn't they?
They did.
Absolutely. They know, though, to be taken seriously, they've got to be clean and have no mistakes or few mistakes in their program to be competitive, and that's just the way it is.
Maybe a sign of more maturity, too, after the early stumble, but gathering themselves and really getting stronger as the program went on. Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman of the U.S.
Side-by-side triple toe loops posing a little bit of a problem for John. Watch his landing as he just buckles with the right leg, but getting it right back here. The throws were exceptional. Beautiful throw triple loop. I love Kyoko's back on that. Very good. This is the throw triple Saukow. Takes off a backward inside edge. John throws her just right for a successful landing.
5-4. 5.6.
Well, tomorrow, Moskvina is always upbeat, but she's got a little more of a gleam in her eye right now. She's happy about that.
I think she's very proud of them.
Technical merit marks in the 5.4 to 5.6 range.
But still, these are good marks for them. They turned in a very nice performance, and there you go, the presentation.
5.6 up to 5.8. You hear the crowd, a lot of school kids here in the upper deck, and awfully excited to be here and watch Enon Zimmerman, the reigning champs, at least for the moment, go into first place.
5.6 and 5.6.
Still to skate, the leaders after the short program, Sal A and Peltier of Canada. But up next, Xue Shen and Hongbo Zhao of China, trying to win gold for the first time in this event in their careers, after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Later this afternoon, the 96 world champ is going back to that event for the first time since 98, and he is the leader after the short program. He took the ice determined to skate better than he did at the U.S. Nationals, where he captured the silver medal. You may remember he missed his quad in the short program there. Didn't try it here, but the triple axel dead on, and as always, the name of the game for Eldridge, his spins. And after skating here, he told us he loves this Olympic venue.
Felt good to get out there and do a good program, and the ice here is fantastic. So I mean, that's one of the greatest things. You know, for us as skaters, when we go out there, as long as the ice is good, you know, the crowd's up a little high, but yeah, so it's not as close, but that's okay.
Well, the skaters all week have raved about the ice surface here. They love it.
They're here to represent
a controversy
China.
In terms of this center Please for the Olympics and figure skating. The first row is way up, so the skaters feel like they're in a bowl. Plus, there are a lot of obstructed view seats here for the spectators.
Well, you just, when you're skating, you feel like you're looking at a wall, and you're so used to seeing people, and you interact with those people. Sometimes they can inspire you. You can get electricity in the building.
Of course, the ice, though, the most important
thing. That is the most important thing.
Everyone has said it is absolutely perfect.
All right. Xue Shen, Hongbo Zhao of China, the two-time and reigning world silver medalist, in second place, trying to win gold here in Salt Lake.
And their music is Spirit of Spring. Electricity and power in their skating. They're opening with side-by-side double axles, stepping into triple toes. Here are the double axle. Nice, right. Good speed in between. And now into these triple toe loops. Very difficult, their unison was right on.
And that is just a sampling of what we're gonna see. Let the fireworks begin. They get great height on their split triple twist.
And now again, these side-by-side triple toes. Very nice, they are solid, at least so far.
Here's the triple twist I was talking about. Watch this. Phenomenal.
Because of the height, because of the speed of the...
The way it covers the ice like that.
That is spectacular.
You're just in awe when you watch them skate because of the athleticism.
Where do they need to grow?
Well, I think in their finesse of the smaller things, all of the choreography, the steps, the finishing off of moves, pointing toes, I think that's where they could really improve. So much excitement. Oh,
yeah.
The air she gets, it's just tremendous.
You actually kind of hold your breath and hope that she lands okay. It doesn't get her hurt. She's so high coming down out of there.
Mm-hmm. these moves right here, they could be a little more important, more stretch, more speed.
Exceptional ending. Watch him lift her, both skating forwards. So hard to take off like that because you are both going forwards.
And it flows so well. That was wonderful.
Hard to beat.
They set such a high standard in pair skating with their speed, their throws, and the dynamic they create.
And they just put a lot of pressure on Selle and Peltier, even though the Canadians led after the short program. Xuei Shen and Hung Bojiao of China, outstanding here.
And here is this wonderful split triple twist that they did earlier in the program. Watch the height that she gets. She is way up in the air. Incredible. And this is what they're really known for, are these throw jumps, this throw triple loop. Look at the heights she gets and the distance she travels. It is spectacular. And that great position on the landing. And this other throw, triple saukow, that same height, then confidence in the landing.
5.8.
You've got to expect extremely high marks now following that performance. The first set. For technical merit, Shen and Zhao of China. There they are. Wow, 5.7 up to the high of 5.9.
Very well deserved.
Absolutely, but this is putting a lot of pressure on the Canadians right now with these high marks.
Absolutely.
What about the presentation marks, which oftentimes split the difference? 5.7, 5.8, that's the range.
That's the area they need to improve, the presentation, the style.
Xuei Shen and Hung Bojiao of China, the two-time and reigning world silver medalist, into the lead over Ina and Zimmerman. Backstage, getting ready to skate next, Jamie Selle and David Peltier of Canada. They burst onto the scene last year, and right now they're in the lead here in Salt Lake City, trying to win another international title. Team together now for only 2.5 years. The charismatic duo of Jamie Selle and David Peltier have become the pride of Canada in pair skating. Recently at the Canadian Nationals, they defended their title, but it wasn't easy. Jamie faltered on the side-by-side triple jumps in the free skate. As the performance went on, though, they pulled it together. And in the end, the reigning champs prevailed. But it took a game effort, once again reminding them that you can never take anything for granted.
Nationals is always the worst one for us. It's very nerve-wracking, and you want to skate so well because you have to make that spot, and you feel like you have something to prove to keep that spot, and it's tough.
And so far, so good for Jamie and David here in Salt Lake City. They'll try to defend their title here at the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships presented by MCI WorldCom next. Here's Free Skate continues here in Salt Lake City at the ISU Four Continents Figure Skating Championships presented by MCI WorldCom. David here in Salt Lake City will try to defend their title here at the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships presented by MCI WorldCom next. Here's Free Skate continues here in Salt Lake City at the ISU Four Continents Figure Skating Championships. World silver medalist Shannon Zhou in lead over Ina and Zimmerman, the two-time U.S. champions, but the gold medal on the line right now, because here are Jamie Selay and David Pelletier. They've won the Canadian National Championship the past two seasons, and they're in their lead after the short program.
This couple has such a nice magic with the audience. Their opening move is this throw triple loop.
Look
very
at the way
secure.
She controlled that. Mm-hmm.
Now these side by side triple toes. Very nice.
Beautiful.
As Peggy mentioned earlier, a much different style than that of Shannon Zhou, who are more about explosiveness and power. This more the feeling of the program and the charisma. It's got to be tough for the judges.
It's a matter of taste.
Mm-hmm.
This is the detail that you really have to have. And Jamie certainly has it. Every movement finished.
And the connection with the music, this is what they do so well. Just throw triple sow cow. Very nice.
Judges put them in first place over Shannon Zhou in the short.
Now coming up are these side-by-side double axels. Jamie's had a lot of trouble with this jump in the past, but not tonight. That's wonderful. They seem real connected tonight and really on.
To a lovely tabletop, right to the music, beautiful crescendo.
And this forward inside death spiral, real trademark move. That entrance with the spread eagle.
Come on.
wonderful.
That was a 6.0 performance.
Oh, yeah.
Mm.
Yes.
Perfection, says Peter Carruthers.
And all the audience here, I mean, they're standing up.
Everyone on their feet here. Xue Shen, a little bit of a smile, but plenty of Canadian fans in the Delta Center. And they know that they just saw perhaps the best performance here. Jamie Selle and David Pelletier will have to wait for the judges, but that was remarkable.
This was absolutely perfect. Nice air position, but watch the landing. Look what she does with her arms. So much control that she can go right into character and put her arms in back. So hard to do. Throw triple Saukow, taking off of the backward inside edge. They have very good throw technique. Notice how he just assists her. He really doesn't throw her. Just what you need. And this was a turning point for them, getting through these side-by-side double axles. Excellent.
Now, Shen and Zhou draw an applause from the audience of thrill and excitement. They bring everybody out of their seats. But Selle and Pelletier draw, talk about applause, but appreciation or even empathy. You relate to what they're doing on the ice.
They really draw you in emotionally. It's a real complete package with their program.
5.7 up to 5.9 for technical merit. Now, the presentation marks you would expect very well. Peter called a 6.0 performance. There you go, Peter.
Well deserved.
It was wonderful. They certainly deserve it.
Selle and Pelletier win the gold medal here at the Four Continents Championships for the second straight season. Shen and Zhao, their first trip to this event, they will have to settle for the silver. But they were terrific, too. Hard to pick apart their performance at all. But the Canadians finish with gold. Well, the Canadian champions gain important momentum heading to the Grand Prix final and the World Championship. Shen and Zhao the silver, Ina and Zimmerman the bronze. Pang and Tong move up from sixth to finish fourth. The Wurtzes from Canada were fourth after the short program. They finished seventh. Peter, how do you break down who had the edge between the top two?
Saw two outstanding teams, the Chinese with their amazing throws, but the Canadians really had the complete package.
Right now, let's join another member of our crew, Susie Wynn, who is with the champions now. Susie?
Thanks, Terry. You guys are wonderful, awesome. Now, a perfect performance in the Olympic venue. How do you maintain your composure with such the deep field and the competitiveness of this para event?
Oh, it's very easy. I think we're very focused on our job here, and we were totally not thinking about it being an Olympic thing, and we just wanted to use this as a practice sort of thing, like everybody has pre-Olympic year, and we're just so excited to be here. The crowd wasn't as big as it will be in Olympics, but they were still wonderful, and they fed off of it, and we fed off them, and each other, and we just had a good time.
Now you're going on to the Grand Prix final. What do you have up your sleeve for Worlds and the Grand Prix final?
Well, the same thing as we've been doing all year. I mean, we try to skate from our heart and because we love it. We don't skate for the money. We don't skate for being famous. We just skate because we love it. And we're going to keep focusing on this thing.
Well, it's all working. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
Terry, back to you.
All right, Susie, thank you. The men get their turn next. The five-time U.S. champion, Todd Eldridge, getting ready. He hopes this is a precursor to the Olympics. He's in the lead right now.